Hey guys, welcome back to the Wizard of War Restore. This is going to be part number 11. Now, what I screwed up with last night is on these leaf switches for the joysticks. Player 1 and player 2 have these other wires that need hooked up. So what I did was I found, through a lot of digging, these leaf switches, which are from Pac-Man joysticks. I need to add another leaf to them. So I can easily add another leaf like that, which creates a second contact, which creates another leaf to hook up. So now I'll be able to hook up the purple wire. The purple wire is to move slowly. If you press it lightly, or if you press it full, the guy moves all, you know, fast. So I need to basically unsolder all these wires, take all these leaf switches out, replace them with these that I'm going to make, and resolder all the wires on. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to, off camera, take all this apart. I'm going to get the new ones screwed in, and then we'll come back and we will solder these on. And then hopefully I have that correct. So let me go ahead and do that, and then I'll come back in a little bit. Okay, I got the first set done. Don't know if I can, you guys can see this that well. Let me tilt this. So the first set's done. So now I'm gonna solder these wires up on this one, and then I can go ahead and do the other one off camera. So I'm gonna kind of try to keep this tilted towards you, so you can kind of see now how this is going to work out. Okay, so now what we have to do is, this is our down. The ground wire, which is the browns, go to the middle leaf switch. The orange on this one goes to the first one. So all the colored wires go to the first leaf switch, the ground is middle, and the purples go to the far outside one. And then I have to do some adjusting and stuff like that on the leaf switches. Okay, so that's how it's going to look. The colored wires first, the grounds are in the middle, the purple wires are on the total opposite outside edge. Other side is going to be the same way, ground in the middle, and all the blue wires go on the outside, and then the colored wires go on the inside. So I'm going to go ahead and finish up these. I'm probably just going to go ahead and finish up this control panel, and then we'll come back and look at it. There's no point in making an hour-long video watching me re-solder wires onto these. Okay, this is all together. I have to adjust these still. They're too far apart, some of them, and bent a little weird. But once I get them all adjusted up, they should work. They're wired correctly and everything. So now what I need to do is come over here, and I'll have to set up the tripod, but I need to take this end off, and this is for the coin door. Now, I don't have any more female 12-pin Molex connectors. But if you see here, we're not using all the connectors anyways. So I'm gonna pop these out of here and we're gonna go with a 9-pin connector because we're using 8 pins here. So we'll just put a 9-pin male on here and a 9-pin female on here and we'll be able to plug them in just fine. Doesn't matter because clearly we're not using them all. And this harness is gonna stay with this cabinet anyway, so I don't really see it being a problem. So let me go get the tripod, I'll bring it over here, and we will start swapping out this connector. Okay, let's work on swapping out this connector. Size these are. Clearly bigger than that. I'm going to have to get the wiring diagram so I know what wire does what, because it's not going to match the color on the ones on the coin door. I don't know if this one's too big or not. I think this one's too small. Nope, this is it. There we go. Sometimes these can be a pain to get out. Sometimes you actually have to push them in before you can pull them out. Now these Molex pin removers, I got them on Amazon a while ago, and they're awesome. They work really well. I can't remember what I paid for them. I don't think it was too bad, maybe $30 or so, but the time it saves, and they have a nice handle on them, so you don't have to worry about like cutting your palm of your hand all up and stuff like that. But now I'm gonna go get the wiring diagram and then we're gonna put a 9-pin on here and we need, oh, I put that away and I need to take these pins out. So these are females. These are also females. So we're gonna have to cut this off. So I might as well just cut it. There's no point in releasing the pins if I have to change them anyways. I'm just gonna throw this plug, well, I'll probably save the plug. But let me go grab the manual and we'll start cutting these off. All right. Let's cut these off. There's only 6 wires on this coin door. And actually there's 8. The coin mech, or the, I don't know what it's called anymore. What's that thing called? Meter, coin meter, that's it. So I'm going to strip all these so that we can put pins on them. Okay, there's 4. These are the other 2 here.
Okay, so we have six wires, like I said. But I see a blue one. They're just using that as a jumper. And then there's these two blue ones, which turn to red and black. These are for the bulbs. So the red and black are for the bulbs. But first, what we're going to do is we're going to stick all the male pins on so that we have those out of the way. Six of them. Make sure that these are the right ones. Yes, okay. I'm gonna have to probably double crimp them because these are some pretty thin wires. So what I do for double crimping them is I start at the biggest one and then I go to the middle one. And these actually go pretty quick once you get used to using the tool. I did order a high score saver kit for this game. I haven't gotten an email yet saying it's been shipped, but I'd imagine I'll have it by next week. So we'll probably do another video for the high score saver. High score saves, whatever it's called. I didn't realize I can get the one with just Wizard of War. I thought I had to get the one with Roto Robbie and Wizard of War. And it was a lot more expensive, so I just got the Wizard of War one. It was only $60. The other one, I think, was like $120 or $110. And I really don't have any interest in playing the other game. I don't even know if it's a fun game or not. I actually know where there's one for sale right now. The Roto Robbie cabinet, but it doesn't have that game in it. Okay, our ends are all on. So we are going to put a 9-pin male. Probably help if I'm using the right side. Okay. So now, let's just put these, I guess, well, let's do one at a time probably. So I gotta find on my schematic here the coin door wiring. Coin meter. Ugh. Here we go. Coin switch one, brown and black. Coin switch two, brown and white. That's why we're missing some wires. Coin switches one and two are series together, which I'm just gonna leave it like that for now. I don't know that it really matters. So, I can see what's going on here. Okay, I think orange is the ground. So coin switch, let's just hook it up to coin switch one. Brown and black. Right here is brown and black. Let's put that in this pin here. Let's find the corresponding one here, which is going to be this top one here. Put the purple one in there. Okay, then right next to it, we're looking for looks like orange is the ground. It goes to the other side of the coin switch. Orange and red. Yep, orange and red. So that's going to go right next to it. So we're going to take this one and put the orange right next to it. So technically the coin meter should be hooked up, or the coin mech should be hooked up. Okay. Now, test switch we don't have on here. As of right now, there's no test switch. So we have the light bulbs, which are, see if I can find those. Coin meter. Looks like a coin meter is gray and white, brown and red. Okay, no. Gray and white, coin meter one. Green and green and white, I think. Here's a green and white. Green and white. Brown and red. Black and red. I keep thinking B is brown, and I gotta remember that B is black. Okay, let's put the green and white on the third pin. Put the black and red on the fourth. What's brown and white? I need a blue. Right here is blue. Okay, so basically the blue is our ground for the coin meters. Because it looks like both coin meters tie to the blue. And I'm not sure which one on here is ground. I don't know that it matters or not. Probably does, but I don't know. So we can always switch the pins. So now, if we have this plugged in, the green one, and then the center of the second one. So we'll put this one here. And then we'll go to the center of this one here. Okay. So now that's all we have left of the light bulbs. Which I have to find on here. Test switch, tilt switch, coin switch, coin switch. You know, we can kind of eliminate it. We have a... what's the brown and white here? Brown and white is coin switch two. Let's just stick that down here. Now we have this yellow, white and yellow. yellow and black, and a white and yellow. Okay, this plug is not showing anything for lighting up the coin door. Does this game not have a light up coin door? But there's another plug over here that might be for that. Right here, this plug. I'll have to look at that. There's a orange and red and a white and blue. Orange and red and a white and blue. I'll have to put a meter on that and see what that is. We can worry about those in a few. But I don't want to take up all the slots on here. I'm going to leave this one out for now. Mainly want to see if this thing's going to coin up. Let me go in the back and I'm going to plug in the monitor. We'll see if this thing turns on and wires. Okay. Let's see if this turns on. I thought I fixed this lower switch. Okay, I did. All right. Put one of these latches on. You know what? I'll just pull the button out for now. So basically, I want to see if this thing will coin up. Insert coin. Let me grab the control panel. It's tight. Now, I'm not sure that I have these player one and player two. That was the only thing I was worried about, is I picked the wrong prong to solder them to. So let me go switch that and then I'll come back. Okay, let's get this control panel put back in here. That's enough to drive you nuts. And noise. Thank you. I have it right here. Orange, now the leaf switches are not adjusted right either. So doesn't want to go up real good. I wonder if the player start buttons are stuck on.
Come back for more. With a wizard of lore. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. I see a wizard of lore. Find me a wizard of lore.
Let me recredit it and see if it starts automatically. If it does, I have these wires in the wrong place.
You
never
told you don't find me a wizard of lore.
Might be alright. They're on the wrong order. They must be stuck open. Yeah, this thing, I gotta do some major adjustments to it. Definitely is not wanting to go up. Okay, so I need to fix those wires again. Try the other port. Okay, let's see if this works. Just gonna leave it up in the air a little bit.
Find me a wizard of lore. Hey, enter join. You're off to be a wizard, a magic, a wizard of lore. Ta 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 ta. My lore wings are very, very hungry. Ta 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 ta.
I believe we got it.
I'll fry you with my lightning bolt. Your bones will fly in a dungeon of war. Ha 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 ha. I'll fry you with my lightning bolt.
Okay, now I'm gonna turn it off and back on just to see what it does. I want to try the player two start button.
I know the fight. Ha 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 ha. Get ready for your welcome to my world of lore. Welcome to my world of lore.
Let's try the player two start. Okay, player two is not working. Let's try player one. Player one's working, player two's not. I need to switch the wires on the player two. So the player two, or, you know what, I think I need a jumper wire for the negatives, because I separated them. That's probably what the problem is. So let me go do that now, and then we'll see if that'll work. All right, let me turn it off again. Turn it back on. I want to plug this in while it's on.
Find me However, not slower.
Alright, so let's try player 2 button again. There we go.
If you can speak correct, then you will never get the best. Ha 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 ha.
Like I said, I gotta adjust all this stuff. Doesn't want me to go up right now. Okay, so we know that those are all working. Let's put the monitor surround on. And the glass back on, and then we'll probably stop this video, and then I will get this control panel all straightened out, and we can do one more video wrapping this up other than the high score saver, unless it comes in the next day or two, but I don't see that coming that quickly. Turn the game back on. Shoot. Right. Okay, that's latched. So now we just have to screw this on. This plastic's a little oblonged out. Let me go grab two washers and a couple screws. I did wipe the screen yesterday. Probably wipe it off one more time real quick. Dust off that's on it. So there's just a few things left to finish up. Need to do some of the final wiring cleanup in the cabinet. I want to get power to the coin door for the lights for the coin door. I got to check the voltage on that other available plug. I don't know what it is. And then I need to clean up the contacts and adjust them for the joysticks, which I'll probably do that on camera so you guys can kind of see how I do it. And then the only other thing we'll have to do after the next video is going to be the high score saver. So other than that, that's going to wrap up this video. This is part number 11 of Wizard of War. We have it playing. We have it making noise. It talks. I am getting nothing out of this left speaker. So when I move the controls in the coin door for the left speaker, it'll make some static sound. So I don't know if the pot is bad on that or if there's something else wrong with the left speaker. Or if you guys know, does that left speaker only work sometimes for certain noises? I'm not sure. I honestly haven't had to play it really much yet because, as you can tell, the controls aren't working yet. So, all right, guys, this is going to end part 11. If you like what you're seeing, please like and subscribe. Any questions or comments, please send them, and I will respond. All right, guys, you guys have a good night, and I will see you tomorrow.